Alternating Currents, Class 7. In this class, I have discussed LC oscillations, that is also known as electromagnetic oscillations. In this topic, we have covered the following topics: equation of SHM for charge, frequency of LC oscillations, variation of charge and current with time, variation of electric energy and magnetic energy with time, and finally, questions related to the topic.
Hello students, good morning. Welcome in my class. We have discussed so many classes related to chapter alternating current. And today we are going to discuss very important special topic, that is LC oscillations. Inductor and capacitor. LC oscillations, inductor and capacitor produces oscillation. But before discussing this LC oscillations, we are going to recall class 11th chapter, oscillations and waves. In class 11th, oscillations and waves, we have discussed so many type of oscillations. For example, we can consider the example of spring and mass. If this mass is stretched from its mean position and then release, then it will perform simple harmonic motion, or we can say oscillations. Such type of oscillations are known as mechanical oscillations. Or we can also consider the case of a simple pendulum. This is a simple pendulum. If we displace the pendulum from its mean position by small displacement, making an angle theta, and then release, then it will perform simple harmonic motion, or we can say it will perform mechanical oscillations. In mechanical oscillations, what happens? Here it is mean position. When we displace the particle up to this point and then release, then kinetic energy converts into potential energy and potential energy converts into kinetic energy. Such type of oscillations are known as mechanical oscillations. It means यहाँ पे काइनेटिक एनर्जी और पोटेंशियल एनर्जी एक दूसरे के साथ एक्सचेंज हो रही है, बट द टोटल एनर्जी इज कॉन्स्टेंट, देर इज नो चेंज इन टोटल एनर्जी. टोटल एनर्जी हमेशा क्या रहेगी, इसमें कॉन्स्टेंट रहेगी. इफ वी कंसिडर आइडियल सिचुएशन, इट मीन्स इफ देर इज नो एनी फ्रिक्शन, देर इज नो एनी रेसिस्टिव फोर्सेज, देन इन आइडियल सिचुएशन टोटल एनर्जी रिमेन कॉन्स्टेंट, बट एनर्जी कन्वर्ट्स फ्रॉम potential energy to kinetic or kinetic to potential. Such type of oscillations are known as mechanical oscillations, and these LC oscillations are known as electromagnetic oscillations. They are known as electromagnetic oscillations. Electromagnetic oscillation. It means if we consider mechanical oscillations, then kinetic energy converts into potential and potential converts into kinetic, but total energy remain constant. And in the similar manner, when we discuss LC oscillations, then electric energy converts into magnetic energy and magnetic converts into electric energy, but total energy remain constant. Such type of oscillations are known as electromagnetic oscillations. Such type of oscillations are known as electromagnetic oscillations. Now, from previous chapters, we know very well that energy stored in an inductor. I am writing first the formula, then we start the derivation. Energy stored in an inductor is given by half L I square. Energy stored in an inductor is given by half L I square, and inductor store energy in the form of magnetic energy. Then we can write UV equals to half L I square. That formula you already know very well from previous chapters. And similarly, energy stored in a capacitor is in the form of electric energy, or that can be written as Q square by 2C. It means here we have connected one inductor, one capacitor. Inductor is having energy in the form of magnetic energy, and capacitor is having energy in the form of electric energy, and when we combine this inductor and capacitor, then they will perform electromagnetic oscillations, that is armature coupling. So now we are going to discuss LC oscillation in very detail. This formula we will use in the upcoming section of this topic. LC oscillations, now we are discussing LC oscillation. In LC oscillation, that is performed by LC oscillator. So what is LC oscillator? A capacitor that is initially fully charged. A charged capacitor is connected with an inductor. A charged capacitor is connected with an inductor and left at t equals to 0. It means initially the capacitor is fully charged and the charge is Q naught. Initially the capacitor is fully charged having value Q naught and it is connected with an inductor. As soon as we connect it with an inductor and switch is on, then charge in the capacitor starts decreasing and current through the inductor starts increasing. Charge in the capacitor decreases and current in the inductor increases. And just we have recalled that a capacitor store energy in which form? Electric energy. Inductor store energy in which form? Magnetic energy. So since initially electric energy is maximum, as charge decreases, the value of charge will decrease. As charge decreases, the value of this electric energy will decrease, while the value of magnetic energy will increase. After some time, electric energy becomes zero and magnetic energy becomes maximum. And after that, again the cycle starts. Magnetic energy starts decreasing and the electric energy starts increasing, and this type of oscillation or this type of process take place, that is known as LC oscillations. Initially T equals to 0, Q equals to Q0. Let at any time T, after T equals to 0, at any time T, current in the inductor is I, current in the inductor is I, and charge on the capacitor is Q. At any time, after starting, at any time, current in the inductor is I and charge on the capacitor is Q, then using Kirchhoff's second law, if we apply Kirchhoff's second law over this loop, then we can say VC plus VL equals to 0. Voltage across capacitor and voltage across inductor, VC plus VL equals to 0. And therefore we can write, I think you all know very well, VC, that is for capacitor. We know that for capacitor Q equals to CV. For capacitor Q equals to CV, therefore VC can be written as Q by C. This VC can be written as Q by C. VL, again from chapter electromagnetic induction, we know that VL equals to minus L di by dt. Or we can say induced EMF. Since the current is variable here, therefore EMF will be induced in the inductor, and the induced EMF is given by minus L di by dt, that we can write here minus L di by dt equals to 0. And since just we have discussed current decreases, charge increases, or charge in the capacitor decreases, then current on the inductor increases. Therefore, here we can write I equals to minus dq by dt. Generally, we are writing I equals to dq by dt, but here charge on the capacitor decreases. In that case, current through the inductor increases. Therefore, I can be written as minus dq by dt. And therefore, we can put the value here. Q by C minus L d by dt over minus dq by dt or equals to. And now we have to solve this equation. If we proceed further, then this minus sign will be plus, and we can write this term as first L, and it becomes double differentiation d to q by dt square, that is double differentiation of charge, and plus q by c equals to 0. L d to q by dt square plus q by c equals to 0. Again, I am revising this. Let I is the current at any instant of time, q is the charge at any instant of time. If we use Kirchhoff's second law, then Vc plus Vl equals to 0. I think you are understanding very well. From unit current electricity, we know what is Kirchhoff's second law. Vc plus Vl equals to 0. Vc can be written as Q by C, and Vl, that is induced EMF in the inductor, that can be written as minus L di by dt equals to 0. And since current I can be written as minus dq by dt, therefore q by c minus L d by dt, and this is the value of current. And finally, we get this equation, L d2 q by dt square plus q by c equals to 0. And now we can modify this equation. We can write as d2q over dt square plus 1 by lc into q equals to 0. And now I think you can easily recall this equation. This type of equation is of simple harmonic motion. This equation is the differential equation of simple harmonic motion if we replace this 1 by lc by omega square. If we write 1 upon lc as omega square, then this equation becomes d2q by d2 square plus omega square q equals to 0. This is the differential equation. This is differential equation of SHM. This is differential equation of SHM. It means from this equation, it is clear that charge on the capacitor will perform simple harmonic motion. Charge on the capacitor will perform simple harmonic motion with angular frequency omega equals to 1 by root LC. Here frequency of oscillation is given by omega equals to 1 by root LC, or we can write omega equals to 1 by root LC, or nu equals to 1 upon 2 pi root LC, that is frequency, and this is angular frequency of oscillations. And the solution of this equation gives the value of charge at any instant of time, and which can be written as q equals to q naught cos omega. It can be written as q equals to q naught cos omega t. And now from this function, we can easily understand that the value of charge will perform simple harmonic motion. So this is the expression for charge. And now we can also find the expression for current. I equals to minus dq by dt. I equals to minus dq by dt. If we put the value, we will get q naught cos omega t. And now if we differentiate this, then we know that this q naught is constant, can be taken out. minus q naught, and differentiation of cos omega t will be minus omega sin omega t. Here this minus, it becomes plus q naught into omega. It can be written as I naught, that is peak value of current, and finally we get the answer I naught sin. And now it is very clear that charge q equals to q naught cos omega t and current I equals to I naught sin omega t. Both the functions are performing simple harmonic motion. Both the functions performing simple harmonic motion. I am writing the value here. Q equals to Q naught cos omega t and I equals to, these are the values. Q equals to Q naught cos omega t, I equals to I naught sin omega t. And now we can easily understand that the charge will vary according to sine function and I will vary according to, charge will vary according to cos function and current will vary according to sine function, but both will perform simple harmonic motion. Such type of oscillations are known as LC oscillation. Now we are going to consider different values of time. Here I am writing the value of time, okay? Then here we can write the value of q. Here we can write the value of I, and consequently we can write the value of electric energy as well as magnetic energy. At t equals to 0, first case I am considering, at t equals to 0, from this equation it becomes cos 0. Cos 0 is 1, therefore q equals to q naught. And sin 0 is 0, therefore I equals to 0. It means initially at time t equals to 0, charge maximum, current minimum, and therefore charge maximum, it means energy stored in the capacitor will be maximum in this case, and therefore UE, that is electric energy, UE can be written as q square by 2c, or that can also be written as q naught square by 2c. This is electric energy, and magnetic energy will be zero because current is zero. If t equals to t by 4, if t equals to t by 4, you can easily understand, if t equals to t by 4, then omega t will be equals to pi by 2. How it becomes? Omega is 2 pi by capital T, that is time period, into T by 4, and finally we will get pi by 2. It means whenever T equals to T by 4, omega T will become 90, cos 90 will become 0, and therefore charge will become 0. It means at T equals to T by 4, Q equals to 0. And I, q equals to 0, but I equals to I naught sin 0. Sin 0 is I equals to sin omega t. Omega t is t by 4. Time is t by 4. Omega t is pi by 2. Sin pi by 2 become 90. Therefore, I equals to I naught. It means in this case, when t equals to t by 4, or we can write omega t equals to pi by 2, t equals to t by 4, or omega t equals to pi by 2, charge will be 0 and current will be maximum. Since charge is 0, therefore electric energy becomes 0, but magnetic energy will be maximum, or that will be half L I naught. It means at t by 4, electric energy will be 0 and whole energy converts into magnetic energy. After that, current in the inductor starts decreasing, and charge on the capacitor starts increasing, and therefore when we write t equals to t by 2, that is half of the time period, or we can say omega t equals to pi, then again omega t equals to pi, this is cos pi and cos pi is minus 1, therefore q equals to minus q naught. It means capacitor again fully charged, but polarity is reversed. The positive plate become negative and negative plate become positive. Q equals to minus q naught, but I will be equals to 0. Q equals to minus q naught and I equals to 0, and therefore UE, that is electric energy, that will become q square by 2c, minus square that will become plus. So again it become q square by 2c and UB become 0. It means now we can easily consider initially electric energy maximum, magnetic energy 0. At t equals to t by 4, electric energy becomes 0, magnetic energy maximum. T equals to t by 2, again electric energy become maximum, magnetic energy 0. This process goes on continue, and energy converts from one form to other form. Electric energy to magnetic energy and magnetic energy to electric energy, but there is any loss. There is no any loss of energy because we have considered this ideal circuit. There is no any resistive effect, therefore there is no any loss of energy, and charge and current in the inductor performs simple harmonic motion. Here it is t by 2. We can also consider different cases. This is case number first, t equals to 0, t equals to t by 4, t equals to t by 2. Now if t equals to 3t by 4, we are considering the complete whole circle. T equals to 3t by 4, then omega t will be equals to 3 pi by 2, or that we can say 270. Then cos 3 pi by 2, that will become 0. Therefore q will be equals to 0. And sin 3 pi by 2, that is minus 1. Therefore I equals to minus I naught. Charge becomes 0 and current become minus I naught, but the energy now we consider the fourth case. Now we are going to consider fourth case. So far we have discussed three cases. In fourth case, let us suppose t equals to 3t by 4. T equals to 3t by 4, therefore omega t will become 3 pi by 2. 3 pi by 2 is 270 degree. We know that as cos 3 pi by 2. Cos 3 pi by 2 will become 0. Therefore q equals to, and sin 3 pi by 2, that is minus 1. Therefore I equals to minus I. Q equals to 0, I equals to minus I. And therefore UE, electric energy becomes 0 and magnetic energy is maximum, and there will be no effect of minus sign because current square we are taking in the formula. Therefore half L. And finally, if we can say t equals to t, it means for one complete time period or one complete oscillation, omega t will be 2 pi. Omega t is 2 pi, then cos 2 pi, we have already discussed in previous classes, cos 2 pi will be plus 1 and sin 2 pi is 0. Therefore, q become q0 and I become. Here we can write UE, that is Q naught square by 2C, and UB, will be equals to 0. Hence, we have considered these 5 cases starting from t equals to 0, t equals to t by 4, t equals to t by 2, t equals to 3t by 4, and finally t equals to t. And in all these cases, we have discussed that total energy will remain constant and energy changes from electric energy to magnetic energy and magnetic energy to electric energy. I am also considering one case that is also very important and interesting. If we consider t equals to t by 8, if we consider t equals to t by 8, this question is generally asked in CBSE exams. If t equals to t by 8, in that case omega t will be equals to pi by 4. Omega t will be equals to pi by 4, that is 45 degree. And now I think you all know very well this, that cos 45, that is 1 by root 2, and sin 45, that is also 1 by root 2. Cos 45 1 by root 2, sin 45 1 by root 2. Therefore, in this case, Q will be equals to Q naught by root 2. Q will be equals to Q naught by root 2, and I will be equals to I naught by root 2. Q is Q naught by root 2, I is I naught by root 2, and therefore UE and UB both will be not equals to 0. We will get some value of E, UE, and some value of UB. The value will be Q square by 2C. Therefore, it becomes Q naught square by 4C. Q naught square by 4C. And here we can write half L I naught square. It means we can write I naught square by 2. So here it become Q naught square by 4C and it become 1 by 4 L I naught square. And in this case, electric energy and magnetic energy both are equally distributed. Or we can say in this case, both these value will be equal. U P equals to Q naught square 4C by 4C, and that is half L I naught square by 2. And that we can also prove. In this case, U E, that is Q naught square by 4C. Q naught square by 4C. Since omega equals to 1 by root LC, just we have discussed the angular frequency, omega equals to 1 by root LC, therefore omega square equals to 1 by LC. And therefore, 1 by C can be written as omega square L. 1 by C can be written as omega square L, we can put this value here. Here it is Q naught square by 4. 1 by C we can write as omega square L. We will write omega square L. And just we have seen that when we write the value of current, when we are writing the value of current, I equals to I naught sine omega t. Here I naught, this I naught is having value Q naught omega. So here it is Q naught omega square. It means this quantity will become I naught square. Therefore, we will get half L I naught. 1 by 4, 1 by 4 L I naught square. And this is the magnetic energy. It means at T equals to T by 4, electric energy and magnetic energy are equally distributed, or we can say at T equals to T by 8, T equals to T by 8, or angle theta equals to pi by 4, the value of electric energy and magnetic energy will be equal. And now we are drawing the variation of charge and current. we can draw the variation like this. Here it is value 0, then maximum, then 0. It means this is the expression I equals to I naught sine omega t. I equals to I naught sine omega t. This is the variation of current. And from this graph, it is very clear that the current is performing simple harmonic motion. At t equals to 0, current is 0. Here it is maximum, then it is 0. Again it is minus I naught, and finally it is 0. So this is the variation of current with time. This is the variation of current with time. And similarly, we can also represent the variation of charge with time. At t equals to 0, charge is maximum. At t equals to 0, charge is maximum. Q equals to Q naught cos omega. So this is the variation of current. This is the variation of charge. Here it is 0. Here it is t by 4. At t by 4, charge becomes 0. And at t by 4, current becomes maximum. So from these two graphs, it is also very clear that current and charge both perform simple harmonic motion. Now we consider some questions related to the topic. Question first. What is angular frequency? We are revising the topic so that you can recall that. What is angular frequency of oscillations of LC oscillator? What is the angular frequency of oscillation? What is angular frequency of oscillations, LC oscillations? The answer will be omega equals to 1 upon root LC. Omega equals to 1 by root LC. Second question. What is the ratio? What is the ratio of electric energy? What is the ratio of electric energy to magnetic energy? What is the ratio of electric energy to magnetic energy at t equals to t by 8? What is the ratio of electric energy to magnetic energy at t equals to t by 8? So just we have solved this question. In this case, UE will be equals to UB, and therefore the ratio is 1:1. In this case, the ratio will be 1:1. Next question. I think you are understanding this. Question number 1. What is angular frequency? Omega equals to 1 by root LC. Then what is the ratio of electric energy to magnetic energy at t equals to t by 8? The answer will be UE equals to UB. That is UE by UB equals to 1. Question number 3rd, last question. Energy of LC oscillator. Energy of LC oscillator at t equals to 0 is 240 joule. Total energy of LC oscillator is 240 joule at t equals to 0. Question is that what is total energy? What is total energy at t equals to t by 2? what is total energy at t equals to t by 2. Be cautious, you can think for 1-2 seconds. T equals to 0, total energy is 240 joule. What is total energy at t equals to t by 2? So just we have discussed this topic in very detail. We have seen that total energy remains constant. It does not vary with time. Therefore, the answer will be 240 joule. Whatever be the value of time, the total energy will remain constant, that is 240 joule. So by this way, we can solve questions related to the LC oscillations. Last question till here. Frequency of LC oscillator is 20 radian per second. Frequency of LC oscillator is 20 radian per second. What is angular frequency if value of capacitance of capacitor and inductance value of capacitance of capacitor and inductance of inductor is doubled. That is the question. Omega equals to 20 radian per second. What is angular frequency if value of capacitance and inductance is doubled? Very easy question. Omega equals to 1 by root LC. And that is given 20 radian per second. Now what changes are there? Capacitance become double. It means we get a factor of 2 here. Capacitance become double. Inductance also become double. Therefore, one factor of 2 is there. So we get a factor of 4. And therefore, new frequency will be omega by 2. Here we get 2. Here we get 2. 4. Square root of 4 is 2. Therefore, new frequency will be omega by 2. And the answer is 10 radian. I think you have easily understand this topic. Now we have to complete this topic after considering this type of numericals. Such type of numericals are being asked in the examinations. I am recalling once again, we have considered LC oscillation. Here inductor and capacitors are connected in parallel. Initially, the capacitor is fully charged. Therefore, electric energy is maximum while magnetic energy is zero. After some time, after connecting, charge in the capacitor starts decreasing, current in the inductor starts increasing. And therefore, there is change in electric energy as well as magnetic energy. Magnetic energy converts into electric energy converts into magnetic, but the total energy remains constant. Such type of oscillations are known as LC oscillations, and the frequency of LC oscillations is 1 upon 2 pi square root of LC, and angular frequency is 1 upon root LC. Thank you.